Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and let me see. That doesn't look too good because you guys can't really see. Anyway, welcome to the show. It's video blog or cast, whatever it is, number 20.
Wow, 20. I've actually hit 20. I can't believe it.
So anyway, this one's going to be short. I know every night I say this show is going to be short, but and then I go for an hour, but this one's actually going to be short because I've got to go to bed and get back on my normal schedule. Because it's just getting worse and worse, but I'm not complaining. I'm actually loving it. Tonight I'm starting a painting of Yoda, as you can see. Working on this, I mean, I just barely started. This is like about 20 minutes in. And I'm just trying to get the shapes right. I think his head might be a touch skinny for some reason, but I don't know. Eventually I'll get going. You know, once I kind of get this right, I'll switch to the darker color pencils to start laying in the blacks and then spray it. And, I don't know, I'm just doing this one kind of... Boy, the camera just sucks today. I got that light just bouncing off of there for some reason. But I'm doing it because I just want to do another piece. Kind of like, I'm trying to sort of figure out some stuff, actually. I'm trying to sort of... like lately I've been doing these black and white drawings that you guys have been seeing, like the one, you know, the Planet of the Apes one, and the Maleficent, and Chewie, and all the pieces I've been doing. I've been doing one pretty much every night, and I was going to do one tonight, and then I just started, I don't know, I mean, I was really torn whether I should throw with my airbrush, but I was really kind of torn whether I should just, you know, just follow my routine and do that, or kind of do this. I don't want to start two paintings. I'm still working on the Wolverine piece, but I'm actually going to just set that aside for a bit. Just because, you know, it's going just fine, but there's, you know, it's just such a complicated piece with, like, so many figures that I'm, you know, I'll admit it, I'm getting a little bit, I don't like pieces that drag on, and I'm getting a little bit, not frustrated with it, but just, I mean, I sit down and I'm not just drawing with like passion and everything, and that's when I draw and get things done. That's when I'm passionate about what I'm doing. So I need to kind of just take a few days off from that thing, let it sit there, come back to it, and attack it, you know, and get it done. So, and that's fine. I don't think there's any rush on it, and I'm not complaining about the piece. I really appreciate that commission, and I think it's coming out really nice. But you know, it's gotten me thinking because, you know, with the black and white pieces I've been doing, you know, it's like, I just kind of sit down and start at about 9, and by about 3 or 4 in the morning, I've got one done, and I put it up on eBay, you know. And I like that. There's something just really super, I'll show you guys the one I just did, but it's just super satisfying to do that. That's a reference. Here it is, the Johnny Weissmuller Marine O'Sullivan Tarzan piece. And I really liked the way this one came out. There was just, I debated, man, whether I should actually try this, because the reference was just kind of like, I liked it, but then I thought, well, is anybody going to want this piece? Is it going to be like, is it just going to be a good piece, you know? Because it's kind of a weird design, you know. She's way down on the corner, and he's kind of up here and his arms off doing something, you don't know what. And, yeah, I was just, you know, I kind of wasted an hour just kind of, like, fretting about it before I started really drawing it. And I'm really glad I did, because I love the way it came out. It's just very simple and understated, and I think it captures that kind of old Hollywood kind of look, you know, like kind of like the glamour photo shots that they used to do back then.
And I've always been a real fan of that, and I really love the way this one came out, and it's already got a bid on eBay, so it's gonna sell, which is really cool. But like, what I'm talking about though is like with these pieces, I've really just been like loving drawing them. You know, they've just been like very, just I don't know. I just enjoy doing them, and I think I even said that in yesterday's video that it. You know, just when I don't have a chance to do one, I kind of miss it. But then it's been making me kind of think, it's like the painting should sort of happen like that, you know what I mean? And for some reason, my paintings are kind of getting like bogged down in this kind of, you know, like they're taking day after day. And it's not so much the time that bugs me. I don't mind putting the work in on a piece. But it doesn't seem like I'm working any harder on them, you know what I mean? It's not like I'm putting in like a week's time on a painting that's taking me a week. It seems to be more like it's taking me a week because I'm getting bogged down in just sort of detail that I don't want to say it doesn't matter, because I mean I like detail, but that's another thing that's happening with these, you know, is like when I started kind of drawing like this, like the first ones I did was those Robin Hood pieces. If you look back in the blog, you can find them, and they were smaller, and they were actually roughs for a painting. And I did three or four of them or whatever, and then the guy picked the painting he wanted, and I did the painting. And like those three drawings, like just I just took a day and did them, and then I put them up on Facebook and was just like, you know, just to show them off. I don't even know if I was put them on eBay at that point, but people really reacted to them. They were like, "That's awesome!" And a lot of people were like, "You're calling that a rough? Are you crazy?" You know. And it made me look at them again and just be like, you know, those are really nice, you know. And they're drawn with like kind of an energetic line, you know what I mean? They're drawn like a drawing. And I think all my stuff is kind of like that, but I think these are even a little bit more like that. And so once I kind of did a bunch of those littler ones, and now I'm kind of going bigger, it just seems to be like it's working in the way that I want to work. And I want to sort of explore that more with a painting. And, so anyway, that kind of leads me to this thing here. This Yoda piece. And that's sort of what I did with the Marilyn Monroe piece. Let me grab her, too. Because I did her in about... It didn't take too long. It was about a... Probably a two-day kind of thing. But, you know, it's like... I mean, I really like this painting. It's just... It's got a lot of really drawn qualities. It looks like me, and it has a lot of like my style in it. And I don't know. I want to try a few more. You know, I want to try a few more. And so that's kind of what I was thinking about with Yoda here. If it doesn't work out, I'll just throw it away, and then I'll just ignore it and won't talk about it anymore. But I want to see kind of what's going to happen. You know, and. So anyway, that's what I'm doing here. Oh, let me show you the other print. I've been working on my prints. I think I told you about that. Okay, so here's actually one of my new prints. Hopefully you can see that. And I just went ahead and put it in the store. I know this one's still on eBay, but this is one of the new ones that I'm doing with the new paper, with the archival inks. And I was actually going to wait and do some bags, you know, like I'm going to still buy the bags. And then put like this foam core and slide it in there. But I tell you, I'm actually not even going to bother with the sales off my site. I think I'm just going to go ahead and send them because they look... just so nice the way they are. And it's really cool because I get to keep my numbers. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's like 1 to 500, and I actually can change each one. So the next one will be 2 to 500, 3 to 500. I signed it here. I like to sign with a gold pen. I know that's not... there it is. That's not the artistic way. The artistic way is to sign it, you know, with pencil. But I don't know why. I just don't like that. I like the gold pen. It's kind of like, you know, reminds me of signing comics back in the day and stuff. So, but I figure, I'm thinking, and, you know, if anybody wants to give me some feedback on this, I mean, please do. But I'm thinking like $16.99 is the price for these. Since I'm printing them myself, I can probably go a little cheaper with them. But, I think that's a fair price, probably. And, I'm just really into them, and I'm just going to kind of just start producing them now and putting them in my store and getting that whole thing going. So I want to show those off. What else? I actually don't really feel like drawing right now. It's kind of like funny. I don't know. I didn't actually feel like doing a video tonight, and I just thought, I cannot stop. I can't miss a day. It's just, you know, it's just, I just can't do it, you know, because it's like, I just can't fail at this, so I have to do a video every night, no matter what. And I was listening to Kevin Cross's video just now, like his new one. He's kind of talking about, you know, the troubles he's having in illustration and all that. And, you know, he's really thinking about, like, maybe... You know, it sounds like he's thinking about kind of quitting the stuff that he's doing and just start working on his comics or something. And, I don't know. It's hard to, I mean, it's so hard, like, when you're on the other side of that. Like, when I quit my job earlier this, you know, like last month, you know, it's not been that long. And, because it's just, you just don't want to, I mean, you know, you're just trained as a kid, you know, from Little League on, to not be a quitter, you know, and to not, like, let your friends down and stuff. And God, you know, when you leave that situation, it feels like you are just quitting, like you're betraying everybody, you know. And I don't know, man, I was definitely struggling with it. And, you know, like, he's kind of talking about, I don't know if anybody's watching his videos too, but he's talking about how, you know, like, being an illustrator for whatever he's been, you know, 15 years or something, he's never kind of like walked off a job and been unprofessional or whatever. And I totally see that. But then it's like, you know, on the other side, it's like, what are you doing sometimes? You know, like when I was painting, that was the thing, is like when painting kind of became, like when I'm painting houses, what I'm talking about, just in case anybody's jumping in. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go back to the first video, watch it, and then you'll understand. You know, like when you're thinking about, well, I mean, it's like your job kind of becomes like the enemy in a way, because it's like stopping you. I mean, it's like the thing that's like stopping you from doing like what you need to do to kind of fix things, you know. And then it's like when it is like the enemy or whatever, then, you know, I mean, to not have like allegiance to that is the right thing to do, you know. Not telling him what to do. I'm not even talking to him. Hopefully he doesn't even watch this video. But I mean, it's just, you know, I mean, I don't know. You know, people can get into like crazy things, you know, when you're like, I don't know, what am I thinking about? Like, you know, if you were... This is going to take an ugly turn, but, you know, like, if you were in Jim Jones's compound down there in, wherever that was, Ghana or something, you don't want to go along with everybody and, like, drink the Kool-Aid, you know? Or if you were, like, you know, in World War II and you're working in a concentration camp, you know, you want to open the gates. You don't want to, like, freaking, you know, shoot all the prisoners like they wanted them to when the war was over, you know. It's, I don't know, there's a point at which it's like, you gotta, like, do what everybody's telling you that's wrong, because it is actually right, you know. And if you're the only one who knows it, doesn't make it any less right. But, you know, I don't know, I'm not telling him what to do or whatever, I'm just kind of like, just, it's got me thinking about, you know, just work and what was going on when I left and stuff. And I don't know, there's, this kind of ties into that too, but, you know, like that Boba Fett piece, which I haven't even got up on my site, and I know some people have asked me what the heck happened to it, but, it's actually here, I just haven't put it up yet, it's finished. But I did, it was a commission, just for by weird chance. I mean, nobody, when I worked painting houses, nobody knew I was an artist, hardly. I mean, very few people, but even they didn't never see my work or anything. I was just very kind of private about it. And just by kind of weird chance, this one guy kind of found out what I was doing and had seen some of my stuff and got excited about it and was like, you know, I want you to paint me a commission and everything. And that's actually what that Boba Fett piece was. And I thought, you know, I may as well paint it for the guy when I left. And I haven't been back to talk to him since then. He's probably like the only guy, or maybe one or two guys, that I'd even want to say something to. But I haven't been back at all. You know, I didn't put in my 2 weeks and work 2 weeks. I was like basically quit and walked out the door and never went back, you know. And it's kind of like now I need to like deliver the piece to him and, you know, get paid, of course. And I don't know. It's like I've been gone for a month and, having worked there, it's like I know how it is there. They kind of demonize the people who leave and stuff, and, you know, you're not on the team, you're not one of the players anymore, so, you know, everything that's kind of went wrong for the last 4 months suddenly becomes your fault, you know, whether it is or not. It's just the way it is there, you know. They have a very, like, much like a cheerleader mentality. And, I don't know, it's just kind of like, I need to call him to give him that piece. I may as well show it to you. Let me grab it. Yeah, actually, here it is. Remember this one? I think it's actually on the first video. It's a nice little painting, and I'm sure I could easily put it on eBay and get as much as he was going to give me for it. But yeah, you know, it's just like do you go back in a way? You know what I mean? Even though I'm not going back to work, it's like part of me is just like that part of my life is over. You know? Even my boss called me up, you know, week or so after I left, and he's like, I want to hear about you, you know what I mean? And I didn't even call him back, you know. I don't know, that might be mean or something, but I looked at it like, I mean, it's funny, I really did look at those guys as like the enemy, like they were the ones who were stopping me, and I just didn't want to be softened in any way. I didn't want to sort of feel almost like I was letting anybody down or something. I wanted to keep my, you know, anger or something about leaving, and just, you know, and not weaken in any way, you know. And that might sound kind of stupid, but so I don't know what I'm gonna do with that dang piece. I should probably call him and just, you know, at least let him know. But then it's like I gotta go over to his house probably, you know, I gotta freaking, you know, catch up, I gotta hear what's happening. I don't really care what's happening. I don't really wanna even tell him where I'm going or what I'm doing. You know, it's just, I don't know. It just doesn't really matter so much. I don't even know why I'm bringing it up. Just thinking out loud, I think. And talking just because I don't want to work my pencil. I'm thinking about going to bed and just attacking this thing tomorrow. I also got a pretty cool comment. I thought I'd read that because it had something to do with that one video when I was just kind of showing you how to draw, where you just do the scribble lines and stuff, you know, like I do here, you know. This is a person, Babble Beast, that I talked to on YouTube. She's, I shouldn't say that she, I'm pretty sure it's a girl. But, you know, it just kind of dawned on me, I can't really remember, but, she's like, somebody I knew when I was messing around with animation, and
you know, we kind of just started talking back and forth, and she still messages me sometime. But she always messages me privately. She never just puts something in the video. But she wrote a message. I'm going to read part of it. She says, thanks for sharing your scribbly-feely drawing technique. And she says, Jeff, I think I do that too, but I've not drawn anything seriously for a while. But when I do, I feel like I like to feel out the whole thing and then slowly refine the layers evenly. I've fallen out of the habit of drawing and forgotten how fun it can be. And I think that's exactly what I was kind of talking about, you know. You just, it's kind of like you start and you sort of refine, you know. You just start drawing wrong. I've heard people talk about writing like that, where it's like when you start writing, you just kind of just start spewing out all your writing, you know, and just throw it down as fast as you can, and then you go back and you start to rewrite, like that Hemingway quote, you know, writing is rewriting. But anyway, she goes on to say, You've got a plywood desk, which I do. It's actually OSB, but yeah, it's the same thing. Just talk about the bare minimum. It looks like you've crammed yourself into a humble little room where the walls aren't even finished. You're such a, well, inspiration. I hate to read stuff like that because I don't want to be all cocky about it, but it says, I bet you weren't one of those kids who could afford a pencil collection with every shade under the sun. You probably had the primaries in black and white and knew how to use them. Let's see. And it says, it's so easy to put off doing something creative by telling yourself you need this or that, or the perfect space. One requires so little to actually she kind of drops off that point, but I think basically to actually create art. And then it says a 64 pencil collection does not an artist make. But I thought that was just a super awesome comment, because it so hit the mark on the head. And she's right. I don't know. I've really never been like, I need like North Light and all that kind of stuff. And a great studio, and you know, it's kind of like, just give me like the 60 watt bulb or a couple of and whatever kind of pencil I can find, and I'll make it work and whatever kind of surface. And I think that's a lot of it, you know, that there is no kind of right way. And even though like that way works for me, it's like if you can figure out another way that works, then that's the right way, you know. I don't know. I have always been like, I mean, because it's like even when I paint, I basically, which I guess I should do a video about that eventually, but I only paint with basically primary colors and not black, of course. I put blacks on before, but with white. And I just have a yellow, a blue, red, and white, and then I also have brown. I have some kind of brown, and I like kind of a reddish brown. So it's usually either burnt sienna or this stuff called Tuscan red. And that's pretty much all the colors I use. And it's because I blend them. You know, if you have those colors, your three primaries, I mean, you can actually make everything with just those three. But if you add brown, it just kind of makes it easier to make brown, you know what I mean? You don't have to figure out how to blend it. And I've always had a hard time sort of bringing more color into my work. That's kind of a funny thing, but I remember I used to be friends with a guy who painted also, and he just, you know, he was a guy who was like, I need purple, so I went and bought purple. You know what I mean? And I could never wrap my head around that. And he would just kind of like razz me that I didn't do that. Like my colors were so sparse, and you know. But it's just the way I don't know, that I just never looked at like, you don't need green if you have yellow and blue, you know. You can just make your green. What was I going for there? There was a point, but just that you know, you really don't. I mean, you know, you don't really need anything to like create art, really. You know, I see a lot of these videos where people are using these Copic markers and. Like, I don't know, I played around with markers like a long time ago at art school and was pretty impressed, but they just like marker technology or whatever has just like, you know, increased like exponentially, and now like these Copic markers are like these amazing markers that could do everything like the old time ones did, but like 100 times better, you know, and people are doing like full paintings with these damn things. And I've thought sometimes, oh, I should buy some of those and give those a try and everything, and I don't know. It would be fun to experiment with them, but I don't. It's just there's just I don't know. Like I said, there's just more than one way to skin a cat, kind of thing. You know, it's like whatever you got, you can make art with. You know, that's why, you know, like there's guys, you know, like the natives in like Alaska. You know, carving like polar bears out of like, you know, whalebone and stuff. Or people in Africa, you know, making masks out of like gourds and things like that. I mean, you know, or just even back to like the caveman days, the guys who painted, you know, the caves of Lascaux. I mean, I don't know. It just, they didn't need anything. They just needed their hands and some berries to chew up and stuff, you know. Some chalk they found somewhere, you know. Like a mineral that like resembled chalk, I guess. So anyway, I just thought I'd read that comment because I just thought she just really got the point of that video, and I don't know if I really kind of stressed that at all. That, you know, I think I talked a little bit about how, you know, it's honestly, it's not, you know, the way you're moving your pencil or anything like that. It's like what's going on in your head, and I think that it extends out from there, you know. I mean, just like this board, you know, it's just like I don't buy illustration board anymore, and I used to buy like really nice Bristol and all that kind of stuff, and it's just kind of like went down the line until now I'm painting on MDF, and like even MDF is sort of like, even for guys who paint on like the hardboard, they look down their nose at the MDF, you know. That's like the worst of the hardboards, you know, and I don't gesso, and when people hear that they just go crazy, you know. It's like, well, I mean, it works better to not gesso for me, you know. And there's really no reason to gesso. There's a piece hanging in the Denver Museum, which I don't usually go to museums much anymore, but there's a piece hanging in the Denver Art Museum that's from the 1700s, you know, like Revolutionary War time, and it's oil on paper. And, you know, like anybody who's ever went to art school or talked to any artist anywhere, if you would say something like that, like, I'm going to paint oil, and I'm not going to gesso nothing, I'm going to paint it right on paper. I mean, you know, you just, I mean, I remember this, I used to do these little oil studies in my sketchbooks, and, you know, they'd dry out, and, you know, they'd just be there, you know, it wouldn't do anything. And, you know, I remember telling that to this girl, and she just flipped out. She's like, oh, the oil is going to eat that paper in that sketchbook, and it's going to rot away, and blah, 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 blah. But, I mean, here's like a painting that's hanging that's, you know, 300 plus years old. It's like, well, when's that oil going to eat that paper, you know? It probably is not the best surface to, you know, survive that amount of time. Paper's, you know, very delicate compared to, like, wood or, you know, marble or something like that. But it's just like, you know, I guess that's just my point, is it worked, you know. That piece was painted all those years ago, and now here it is there for me to see, you know, hundreds of years later. And the guy didn't follow the rules, you know. So, I don't know, this video is probably not that great. Thanks all, everybody, for the comments, I really appreciate it. What else? There was just a bunch of really cool comments. Chris Mason left me a really nice one. Chris Hack is, yeah, he was telling me about, I should check out the new stuff from the new Star Wars, and I'm totally going to do that. So
Anyway, I'll turn the camera back on when this one's a little further along, and we'll see what it looks like tomorrow. So, awesome. Tomorrow's video, number 21. So, didn't fail tonight. Keep up, still going. So I'll see you guys later.